Welcome everyone. My name is Dorota Czerny. I'm a geo instructor since 2005. And today I would like to talk a little bit about two different types of equipment configuration. And I would like to introduce now the guest stars of our show today, where the first one will be a GUI configurated equipment set and non-GUI equipment configuration set. I would like to make one statement in the beginning that the models, the brands, does not really matter. What I have here is just two different types of setups, and what I'm covering here is not brand, it's just two different types of configuration that are relevant to us as GUI divers. I would like to start with a little bit of a story of myself, because I started like that, because I'm still coming from the times where we have been using a jacket style BCD, which is that. We did have a regulator which has an octopus or alternative air source. And I was teaching with that equipment for quite a while. In the place where I was training, in Egypt at the time, or in the place where I was teaching, I have met at some point people who have been using that type of configuration. And honestly, in the beginning, I said, what is that? Because I was thinking, like, why they are using a technical diving equipment to dive a single tank in the Red Sea? And I was thinking, like, you can just use that jacket style equipment because this is what I was used to. And I even wrote an article about that, that I said, like, why we should over-exaggerate and use this complex gear if we have something that works? So at some point, out of my natural curiosity, I just tried a different configuration even before I started to train with GUI. And honestly, I said, okay, now I understand what the difference is and I understand what the benefit of it is. So now, being a GUI instructor for quite a long time, I can explain a little bit of the differences between these two. The main, or not really the main, but one of the reasons for us to do that video is as well the fact that now when GUI is training a lot of recreational divers, and we are starting to train our divers with that type of configuration, we are aware that if they go out and dive in multiple of diving locations, they might be challenged with, or they might be confronted with, that type of configuration. So the reason for shooting that video is as well to introduce our recreational divers, whether it's a recreational level one diver or a supervised diver, to a different set of configuration that they might meet. And we would like to explain a little bit of the differences, what our divers can expect to see and what they can expect, how the equipment will behave and it will work. So this is one of the main reasons why we are talking here. And as well, this video would be and is dedicated to people who are just interested to see what the differences are and why GUI would train from the very beginning in a configuration equipment like that. Now we need to introduce our guest a little bit better. And as they can't talk, I will do the talking for them and we'll introduce star guest number one, which is a GUI configurated equipment. We have here a BCD, which is buoyancy controlling device or buoyancy compensator, which consists, in the case of GUI configuration, of a backplate, harness. It does have a crotch strap as well. To that is connected a wing. We do have a regulator, which we would refer to as a long hose configuration or a long hose regulator, because it does have a long hose here, which is around 210 or 6 feet. So you can see it's quite long. It goes around diver's neck, into his mouth, or in case of us here now, it will be clipped off. Then we have their alternative gas source. We call it a backup regulator, which is hanging on a bungee under the chin of a diver. And the last piece, apart from inflation, of course, the last piece, we have an SPG only, that it's connected to a relatively short hose and it's clipped off here to the right, to the left hip D-ring. Guest number one, GUI configuration. Now we are going to guest number two, where we are talking about a jacket style configuration. And here the BCD is, it looks a little bit like a jacket, something that you put on. So that's why it's called as well this way. So we have a jacket style BCD. We do have a regulator that has their primary regulator that they are breathing from here on a hose. Then we have the alternative gas source here, which is on a differently colored hose. It's a little bit longer than the primary one. And very often it is called an octopus. Then, of course, we do have as well, let me just move here, we have an SPG, and there is a console that contains two different gauges, which is a depth gauge and an SPG, and it's on a quite long hose as well. So these are the guests. Guest number one, guest number two is the jacket style BCD. I can tell one thing now, which is the biggest advantage of that style equipment. Because the biggest advantage, or one of the advantages that that equipment has, is that it's so popular. I would say that most of the divers, they know that piece of equipment. And most of the dive centers that people will travel to will have that piece of gear. So for us, it's really very important that our divers, they are aware of that equipment, how it can function, what are the advantages and disadvantages of that equipment comparing to what they are used to have and use. One of the main advantages, one of many, like both of them will have advantages and disadvantages. One of the advantages of this one is that that configuration, as you see it here, is really universal. So it's standardized, which means that if I'm starting as a diver and if I'm using here a single tank, like we have here a configuration of a single tank, I will have very similar configuration if I move on with my diver training. And if I would like to put more tanks on my back, like a twin set, the front of me will look exactly the same because I will have my backplate, my harness, I will have regulators that are configured in a very similar way. I will have my backup on the bungee, I will have my long hose. And then what the things that will change is the wing, because it will have to have a bigger capacity to lift more weight, because then maybe I will have here two tanks. So this is, whatever you learn in the beginning and whatever muscle memory will develop, you will keep it on throughout the whole career as a diver that you will have. Here, it's not the case, because now if you would like to put more tanks on it, you would need to change. You would need to switch to a different style BCD. You will need to relearn, and you will need to get rid of some hobbies that you might already have. So this is, from our perspective, an organization that likes to have standardized gear and base our actions, especially in emergency situations, on muscle memory that is properly trained. This is a very big disadvantage.